Hello and welcome to this final chapter in the Banker's Masterclass series, Consumer Banking Now, in association with Home Credit. I'm Kimberley Long, Age Writer for the Banker, and with me is Jean Lafontaine, Global Head of Funding, Treasury, M&A and Investor Relations at Home Credit, to discuss the importance of consumer credit. So what has been the economic impact of greater access to consumer credit?
As you know, Home Credit operates in nine growth markets or emerging markets around the world. And many of these markets over time have moved towards a more consumer-driven economy. I think this is particularly true in Asia. I mean, in particular in China, but many other of the markets where we are. As you think about it, as governments focus on that transition, consumer credit is clearly an important pillar which will help drive the economic growth in each of the economies. And if you think about it, household consumption in Asia has grown tremendously over the last decade or any period that you want to look at. I mean, the example I look at usually is and have readily available is Vietnam. Vietnam has grown by more than 2x over the last decade and is a prime example of significant transition that we have seen in our markets. The opportunity to enhance people's lives is immense, is really immense. And access to financial services is important, but really underserved. I mean, if we look at a study by the Asian Development Bank, it basically says that less than one third of people in Asia have a bank account. Now, what we also see is that each of these growth markets or each of these markets in Asia that where we are present are growing at something that is roughly high single digit growth rates every year. But consumer credit penetration is less than 6% in the five markets where we are present. What we do see is people's disposable income is increasing. Familiarity with financial services is increasing and improving. And there's clearly significant growth opportunities for consumer credit to continue to drive this forward and to flourish with economic growth in each of these countries. So as we look at our markets in Asia and in particular in Southeast Asia, where we are in the four key markets, I mean, based on ongoing discussion with international consultants and frankly our insight and knowledge of each of these markets, we estimate that there are 600 million people that are a potential target market. I mean, that represents roughly 50% of the population in those markets. Those 50% would be classified as upper to middle mass affluent. What that is traditionally defined as is people with annual income between $1,500 to maximum $15,000. And this is the primary target that is not well served by banks that could benefit from consumer credit in improving their lives. Now, how does consumer credit improve economies economies directly? I mean, I think there's very few data points to show that in Asia that we have come across, right? I mean, we've seen it anecdotally, we've seen the improvement in our customers' lives and how they use it. But if we look at a survey that was done by the IMF in Central Asia, in markets where we are as well, different than Asia, but they estimate there that consumer credit can enhance GDP growth rate by up to 1% on an annual basis and create millions of jobs. And all of that is clear direct improvement of economic impact that consumer credit can have directly on economies. Now, I think it'd be remiss if I didn't say that COVID impacted our business, consumer credit, or economies. I think it's a pandemic that we are all living through that impacted us. It impacted us directly through lockdowns, through reduction in consumer consumption around the world, as there was clearly uncertainty. We are clearly bouncing from the bottom of that, but living through volatile times. But financial services clearly is one of the drivers to help in that recovery. But when I think one of the things which is very important to point out is that COVID probably helped the acceleration of the digital transition in financial services to many players and consumer credit as well. And there has been a clear shift to mobile, to people using their phones or other devices to get credit directly rather than doing it in person, and much more digital-led financial services or other services. And as a result, we believe and we see it that this will impact and have a great impact on consumers' access to consumer lending in the future.
And how does having access to consumer credit benefit previously underserved communities?
I think one of the things which is important is, let's start with the facts, which is based on the Asian Development Bank, only a third of adults in emerging Asian economies have a bank account. So it's clearly underserved by financial services and traditional financial services. Part of the issue is that people have lack of access to transparent lending schemes or focus on these communities. And it's been an impediment. I think that having access improves people's lives directly. It allows them to get their first credit. It allows them to get a phone, their first motorcycle, their first white good to help improve their lives, their businesses, and everyday needs that people have. I think what is important is that people need to be educated. We at Home Credit spend an enormous amount of time about educating people that have been underserved to understand what is credit and how to use credit responsibly in their lives. In 2020, for example, we've calculated that we've had at least over 25 million people who have visited our financial literacy sites around the world to get better understanding of credit and how to use it and to improve their lives. And we are firm believers that consumer credit is central to improving their lives. And it's also an important component as part of ESG, and in particular, the social part of ESG, which is becoming an important movement, as we know, everywhere around the world.
Thank you so much for your thoughts, Jean. And this concludes the Banker's Masterclass series with Home Credit on Consumer Banking Now. Thank you for watching.